Hi everyone, while this is a time lapse, I thought it would be fun to talk you through the process of how I do my drawings. This is a colored pencil drawing. As you can see, I've already done the tires. I started the time lapse after I'd already begun the drawing. I always start out with a pencil sketch first to make sure that I know exactly where everything goes. So you see the pencil on here already. And I work on a section at a time. So I've done the tires. Each one of them are vaguely the same colors, so I make sure that I have consistency throughout. I'm getting some base coats in here also. I started the grill there with a marker undercoat. Doing marker first, which you'll see in a second for the rest of the truck, gives me a base of something to help the colored pencil really pop. Think of it just like a primer on a truck or a car when you'd have that painted. Well, right now I have the red undercoat and part of the black too. I'm just sort of filling in the lettering and things so I make sure that I have everything in the right spot. Now I've started building up the colored pencil, one color at a time. Lots of different oranges and reds you see. It's not ever just one color. In reflections and all of that, you see other colors. So the chrome is never just silver. There's green for the grass and blue for the sky, different colors for other things nearby, and a whole bunch of different shades of blacks and whites and grays. I have warm gray colored pencils and a cool gray for a bluer tone. The warm gray is a little bit browner or earthier. Now I'm doing some outlines. I've done some you see there on the vent and the hinge and the trim, just to really get those clean and to pop. Some shadows, which are not black, they're blue. As you can see, I've used blue under those handles. And I keep going back and building things up. It's never either just one color, it's built upon layer upon layer upon layer. I used lighter colored pencils to blend the darker colors. So if you see that door right back there, I am started with a black, built up to lighter grays and blended it with the lightest gray or white even. Sometimes I use blue to blend it. If I don't like what I see, I go back and just keep blending other layers, other colors, till I'm happy with what it turns out as. So again, back to the reds, it's not just one shade of red. I think I used 4 or 5 different colors for this particular truck. I don't remember what the name of the color is, but it's the color used on boar's head trucks. So I at least had that to work from to get the right shade. And as you can see, the door is a little bit oranger right now than the back of the truck, so I ended up going back later and making them match a little bit cleaner. Using white to blend it turned the red on the back there a little bit pink, so I had to go and keep tweaking that as I went. And this truck has pinstripes on it, but I knew that if I added those in colored pencil, I would end up messing everything up. So I ended up deciding to go back and do the pinstriping at the end with gouache, which gouache is an opaque watercolor. While I called this a colored pencil drawing, that's the prominent material I used, but there's also the watercolor markers for the base coat, pencil for that initial drawing, and I'm using liner pens, and also the gouache. It's like 4 or 5 different materials rather than just colored pencil. While it's black and red, there's a whole lot of other colors that go into it rather than just those two main ones. The grill is always the toughest part. I don't know why I leave it for last. And remember, shading and blending are the two most important aspects of any drawing ever. So here I go in with some heavy blues, reflections of the sky, of the parts of the truck that are facing up a little bit more. Something I should have mentioned earlier is that you should start with the lighter colors because you can always go over light parts with dark, but you can't go over dark parts with light. As we're coming up to the end here, I hope you picked up some useful tips from this. If you liked what you saw, please remember to like and subscribe to my channel for more like this to come. Thank you so much.